honestly, like 5 years ago, I don't think I ever saw my wife or I, we never saw us owning a gym, you know? Kind of towards the end of my career. I'm 43 now. And, you know, I was like still doing well, still winning a couple championships here and there in my late 30s. But I started working with more riders. And what I was noticing is I would have them working with them on the bike. And I'm like, hey, here's a training program I want you to do. But I knew they weren't doing it because then I'd go swimming with them. I'd go bicycle, work out. And I'm like, you guys aren't doing what we talked about because I could tell. And it would show in the races. And then I'm like, so then I started having them come to the house, training with me 2-3 days a week. And then that turned into like the wife and I are like, we should open a gym. And you know, I became a certified trainer, a sports trainer. And you know, we opened this place 2 years ago from this month, March 2014 is when we opened. And it's blossomed to something that is even bigger than we ever thought. And now we get to work with people that aren't just athletes. So a lot of people don't realize is we work with the mom and dads, average people that don't even know anything about motorcycles or the sport. And that's what we enjoy. We do yoga, we do core, high intensity boot camp, strength classes, and you know, we love having our family, and we call this a family gym because that's what it is. It's really having a good time, but getting results and working hard.
Come on, Chad. Come on, Chad. Come on.
During the off season, I came out here and was working with Destry, and recently, December 23rd, we all went out on a nice ride. It rained out here, and ended up getting a head-on collision and rupturing my spleen, which put me out now for 3 months, and nobody really knows, but I never was released by the doctors. They won't release me because racing is too risky. So I've been spending a lot of time, of course, in the gym with Dez, and Havasu was my first race back. So, you know, going into that, I didn't really know where I stood. And, you know, Destry, you know, we've been working hard in the gym, but, you know, it comes down to seat time. And Destry's one of the best at dead engine starts and stuff. So I've taken a lot of tips from him and was able to pull the whole shot and lead for a little bit. And then just kind of settled into my own pace. You know, I'm not really happy with the fifth, but, you know, at least, like, me and Destry talked, like, it's, you know, I know where I stand. I'm probably about 75-80%. I mean, now it's just, you know, seat time, and just keep progressing, and it'll all come to me. So, and with Destry's help, I mean, there's no reason why I can't be winning races here in the next couple of weeks.
You know, I get to work with a lot, as we talked about many times before, is my elite guys, my athletes I get to work with, the motorcycle guys, off-road, motocross, and me having a motocross background too, which a lot of people don't know, is I raced outdoors, and I just wasn't as successful as I am off-road. And but now seeing my son Cooper coming up, and you know, he's, what people don't realize is he started 3 years ago, and to where he is now, he's 18, and now he's making endurocross main events. He's got some support ride from Husqvarna, and seeing him grow into the rider he is, and surrounding him with the riders we have here, the athletes we have here, for him to understand you know, seeing what Taylor Robert does, Max Gerston, Gary Sutherlin, it's great for him to surround himself with good people that work hard, and I know he's gonna have a bright future. It's just, you know, having fun with it.
Yeah, training alongside my dad's awesome. I mean, there's a lot of times that he beats me, and so it definitely pushes me to push harder and do everything I can to improve myself and hopefully be able to be faster than him one day, because I don't know, he keeps getting older, but I swear he keeps getting faster.
Coolest thing for me probably is Endurocross Series, is now we're competing against each other in the pro class. You know, this is gonna be my last year in racing full time, especially Endurocross, and being able to race the main events and line it up on the gate with him is it's pretty awesome, you know, and people are like, you're gonna take it easy, and I'm like, no way, I'm cleaning the kid out. You know, I gotta make the main. So it's really having a good time, and he trash talks, we trash talk, and I'm blessed to have such an amazing family and being able to race my son at the pro level, which not too many parents get to do.
Yeah, to have my dad be so successful in his career, it definitely makes me want to strive to be the best I can. And he's won 10 major championships, and I hope I can at least win one. To be able to win a pro championship, that's my goal one day, and hopefully that'll become reality.
I've definitely been around this sport for a long time. You know, it was, I was actually a late bloomer. What a lot of people don't know is my wife and I, we had our daughter at 19, and people are like, oh, you're gonna be done racing. You know, you can't race anymore. And I had a great supportive wife, and she's been there ever since as far as, hey, go do this, go do your dreams. And that's what's made me successful is having the team we have with the family and stuff. And I was in my 20s before it took off, and I got into off-road racing, and you know, I got to race with Danny Hamill and Larry Rossler, Ty Davis, there's so many guys. You know, I'm blessed to have a long, successful career for the most part, and you know, I'm definitely very happy with where I'm at right now.